Hello students, in the last lectures we discussed about normal Gman effect in particularly. Now Gman effect is of three kind. One is normal Gman effect, one is anomalous Gman effect, and the last one is Poston-Back effect. So in normal Gman effect, or if we study the Gman effect, in Gman effect we discussed that how a particular atom when placed in external magnetic field, when the valence electron gets when valence electron goes from one state to another state, when they are not in external magnetic field, and some spectral lines got emitted when valence electron goes from one state to another state. But in particularly when the atom is placed in external magnetic field, those transitions or those spectral lines get further splitted in different lines. In many spectral lines, right? So we discussed that, and where these splitting are arising, if we discuss that, and we already discussed it, that when the atom is placed in an external magnetic field, there is a torque happening, and due to this torque, energy gets stored, right? And this is the energy of the interaction, and the final result from here was that the energy, magnetic energy of the interaction is something like this. Mu L has the some dependency on ML, and ML is magnetic quantum number, right? And magnetic interaction energy does also depend on magnetic field. So this was the main important discussion, that initially the when atom was not in external magnetic field, and when the electron goes from one quantum state to another quantum state, now here n can be any principal quantum number, and this may be any state, but del L, the selection rule happens to be here, that del L should not be greater than plus minus 1. So for this, when atom is not in external magnetic field, this is kind of transition from here, this is from this energy level, that electron is going from to this energy level, right? And this is the frequency by, of which the radiation got emitted from here. But when atom is placed in external magnetic field, what happens? These energy levels get splitted in different energy levels, and that those energy of interaction depends on magnetic quantum number, right? And the separation does also depend on magnetic field. So like this, this is the kind of splitting, and we discussed these things. Then further, we studied that when these transition happens, these transition happen with some selection rule, and the selection rule says that del ML should be either equal to 0 or equal to plus minus 1. There cannot be del ML greater than plus minus 1. Okay. So with respect to del ML 0, we get same with the same characteristic frequency, and when del ML is equal to plus 1 and minus 1, there is a corresponding change due to this magnetic interaction, right? So we studied this thing. Now further, if we take some examples with the help of some examples, we try to understand the normal Gman effect and anomalous Gman effect. Now most often in the exam, this question always comes like, what is the difference between a normal Gman effect and anomalous Gman effect? In normal Gman effect, we only consider we don't consider the spin factor. We only consider the angular momentum, orbital angular momentum. So for this example, spin should be zero. For normal Gman effect, spin must be zero, right? If we don't consider the spin effect, or we don't have any kind of spin interaction or like this, then if S is equal to 0, then in particularly we will have normal Gman effect, and we have some kind of singlet state when spin quantum number comes out to be 0, like the interaction happens to be in such a way that the spin interaction comes out to be 0. So when normal Gman effect happens, when we don't consider the spin interaction or the spin effect, so the total angular momentum is only because of the orbital angular momentum. J is only equal to L. So to understand that, we did till this topic in the last class. So today our next topic is some example and basic understanding of the spectroscopic term, through which we will try to understand both anomalous G-Main effect and normal G-Main effect. So this is the important note, that in normal G-Main effect, we ruled out spin factor, or we can say that S is equal to 0 for normal G-Main splitting. So S is equal to 0 particularly here. Okay, like we did this experiment, this example. This is the particular case of this example. I also do this again. So the spectroscopic symbol of these, if I consider this term, then the spectroscopic symbol can be written something like this. The spectroscopic symbol says that N is the total quantum number, or the principal quantum number. 2s plus 1 is the multiplicity or degeneracy. 2s plus 1 is the multiplicity. Now this determines, or we can say from here, we can recognize that what kind of G-Main effect is going to be happen in this case. So for any particular term like this or this, you need to choose what is on the prefix term. Okay, so what is on the upper left corner? So if this is 1, that implies 2s plus 1 is equal to 1, which means from where I can calculate, like for here, and this is L and this is J. So when L is equal to 2, we can write this as D, because this is the orbital now, D orbital. For L is equal to 2, whenever angular momentum, orbital angular momentum quantum number is 2, we have D orbital. Whenever orbital angular momentum quantum number is 1, we have P orbital, and S orbital for L is equal to 0, right? So this is a spectroscopic symbol for any term. Now you may not get this in the examination, that there is no principal quantum number, because when we try to understand G-Main effect, it does not have any dependency. The further splitting of energy levels does not have any dependency of the on this principal quantum number directly. Okay. Now this is the multiplicity factor, this is TL term, and this is J, total angular momentum quantum number. Now if I take this example, 1d2 and this 1p1. Okay, so for 1d2, 2s plus 1 determines us the multiplicity. From here I can see directly that this is a singlet state. One says us that the singlet state, if we would have here 2, then this could have been called as doublet state. If we would have here 3, then that particular term could have said as triplet state. So 2s plus 1 is equal to 1, that implies S can be calculated from here. S is equal to 2s is equal to 0, that implies S is equal to 0. And if I say what is total J, then total J is equal to L plus S. And total J is 2, that implies that L is equal to 2, and J is also 2, because S is equal to 0 for this case. So obviously TL can be said as D orbital. Simply for 1p1. 1p1, 2s plus 1 is equal to 1, s is equal to 0, this is TL. TL says that L is equal to 2 here, so I can write this as, L is equal to 1, because this is 1 and J is 1, so L is equal to 1 here, and for L is equal to 1, we have P orbital, okay? So that's how do we determine any term, that what is the multiplicity of the term and what is the total angular momentum of the term and what is the orbital with respect to that term. So that's how we determine the terms in atomic physics. So this is the spectroscopic symbol, and this is very, very much important. We already discussed this in the earlier lectures. Now the next thing is the particular example. We will try to understand again the example.